First, we need to lay down some groundwork. An inference is reasoning from one thing to another. Maybe I know it's ladybug season. That's one thing. And I see a red splotch on a leaf. That's another thing. From those two things, I might infer a new thing. That there's a ladybug over there. I could be right, and I could be wrong, but it's not a blind belief. It's got some reasoning behind it. Sometimes, we string together a series of inferences. After inferring that it's a ladybug, I might remember that my son loves bugs, and draw the inference that it's a good idea to show it to him. In logic, we call this practice of reaching a conclusion through a series of step-by-step inferences natural deduction. Natural, because it's roughly how we do our thinking in real life. A natural deduction proof just takes this rough, everyday process and makes it very precise. The proof begins with premises. They are the starting points. And each further step in the reasoning has to be justified carefully using valid inference rules to spell out exactly how you made your inference. In the end, a proof lays out an argument in step-by-step fashion so that a reader can follow your reasoning from beginning to end, with no gaps, and fully understand exactly how you reached your conclusion. This video is dedicated to the big picture of proofs, so I'm going to assume you are familiar with symbolic representation and the rules of inference. If not, you can check those out in other videos on this channel. But even if you are unfamiliar, keep watching. You'll still get a good grasp of the overall mechanics of a proof. Here's an argument. Ladybugs are a kind of beetle and are voracious predators. If they are voracious predators, then they are a kind of natural pest control. So ladybugs are a kind of natural pest control. Sounds like a valid argument, but what if we wanted to check the reasoning? Then it's time for a proof. We start by putting the argument in a formal language. Here are the statements symbolized. These are the premises, and this slash marks out the conclusion over here. Think of a proof as a kind of game, and this is the challenge. Can we get from these premises to this conclusion, using the rules of the game? And the rules, of course, are valid inferences. Your first move is always to start a new line, and what you enter on that line depends on the move you make. I want to take the V from line 1 using the inference rule of simplification. Simplification says, if you have a conjunction on a line, then you can break off one side or the other and enter it on a new line. That's what we did here. Now imagine somebody looking over your shoulder as you do the proof, and they ask, wait, how did you infer the truth of V? You can say, well, look, up here in line 1, it says B and V. And the valid rule of simplification tells me if B and V is true, well, then V is true. So we have made a step in reasoning, and we have spelled out exactly how we did it. But we've only arrived at V. We wanted to prove P. So we're not done. Let's create line 4 and look for a new inference to make. Up here in line 2, it says, if V, then P. And here in line 3, it says, V. Well, so P. That form of reasoning is called modus ponens. It says, if you have a conditional on one line, and you have the antecedent of that conditional on another line, you can go ahead and break off the consequent and put it on a new line. So here in line 4, we infer P. We got that P from line 2, and it was line 3 that allowed us to do it. Because 2 says, if V then P, and 3 says V. So obviously P. That's modus ponens. We have now arrived at our conclusion. We proved it. And every step along the way was made crystal clear, citing lines and inference rules. That is a proof. There's a ton more to learn about strategy and the different kinds of rules, but our goal was just to get a broad picture of what a proof is and what it's meant to do. So just as our example proof is now completed, so is this video.